I set new standards.
Facebook Live. What's going on, y'all? All right, so I've been listening to that, and something is in my spirit. Something is in my spirit, y'all. Like the MLMers that want you to believe they're anointed. Like it's God put it on my spirit to tell y'all something. And I'm not making fun of everybody who says that. but y'all know I'm just naturally sarcastic. All right. But no, I want to talk about something. I wanted to do it yesterday, but I ran out of time. So, some of y'all answer your own questions, and some of y'all be telling on yourself. And I'm talking about MLMers. Let me set the scenario for you, okay? So, my company announced long ago, back when Jesus was a child, they announced that it was going to be some kids coming down the pipeline, some sales, some deals, some steals coming down the pipeline. And the minute I heard it, because I'm on the top income earners Zoom, so I kind of had a heads up. I let my team know. I cut a video, right? I didn't even know the price. But I was like, hey, listen, better buy. I always tell people in my private group first. I always tell people on my team first. And then I go to the masses. And so I cut a video when I didn't even know how much the kit would be. I don't need to know how much the kit it will be. All I know is that my company always shows up and shows out. So that's good enough for me, right? So I cut this video. I tell everybody, hey, have your coins ready. We about to do this. They got another challenge. Y'all up here eating these quarantine snacks. Trust me, I know. We're going to get you back looking like a snack. We had great success with our last challenge in December. I already knew we were going to have great success with the spring sexy back challenge. And so it dropped on Thursday. Now, when it dropped on Thursday, you could buy as many kits as you wanted. You had pretty much all day. The kits sold out that night. We sold 10,000 kits in like 10 hours or something crazy like that, right? So everybody was like, oh, when are the kits coming back? When are the kits coming back? And I keep telling y'all this, okay? Because some people are like, well, you know people don't get paid on Friday. Y'all, that's nobody's problem but yours. If you get paid on Friday, it is your responsibility as a grown, rusty adult to start getting paid every day. Because sales, deals, steals, low interest rates, things like that, they don't revolve around your payday. Nobody cares. You know who's supposed to care about your payday? You. And if deals, because trust me, I'm not being mean. I'm coming coming from a place of knowing exactly how you feel. I used to get paid once a month. And was nothing popping on the first of the month when I got paid. Everything happened every other day. It used to tick me off. And that's how I got to this place right now where I am, because I was so disgusted with myself for being in a position to where I couldn't, as a fully grown, rusty adult who did everything that I was supposed to do, who was earning an honest living, I got so mad at myself that I could not only buy the things that I wanted, but also the things that I needed whenever I wanted to. So I took it upon myself to join an industry that I previously made fun of people for doing. I had to humble myself and say, you know what? What I'm doing is not working. And I'm so disgusted with where I am. I gotta try something different. Even if previously I, you know, made fun of it, right? So joined this profession, and now I don't have that issue with saying, oh, I'll only get paid on Friday. If I know it's something I want, if I know it's something I need, then I create the condition to obtain the money for it. Okay? So that's the first thing. Everybody who's like, well, why they release the kits on a Thursday when other people get paid on Friday? Because that's not their business when you get paid, okay? Now, everybody thought the kits were going to run through Friday. So surprise, surprise, when you wake up on Friday and the kits are sold out. Now, they released some more kits on Saturday. Again, people weren't ready. People weren't paying attention. They released some more kits on Monday. Again, people weren't ready. People weren't paying attention. And I'm telling you guys, I have so many people, not just in my company, but in other companies, that are like, how are you recruiting? It doesn't seem like you do that much. And I guess compared to some people, I don't do that much. But let me tell you what I do, okay? What I do is I constantly show people that I'm practicing what I preach. And by that, I mean PD constantly. Now, there are some people that I vent to. I'm not perfect. I am human. So I do sometimes lose it. I do sometimes spaz out. But I have confidence for that. I have people that I can go to and I can be like, and they can be like, all right, let it go, girl. Let it out. But then get back into a high vibration state. Get back into a high frequency mode. Okay? You done released it. Now release it. Okay? Those you gotta have people like that in your life that know how to get you back into a high state. Getting into a high state, you can do it with so many different things. That audio that I started the Facebook Live with, that is one of the things that I like to listen to get me crunk, to get me in the zone, to get me in the mode, to win, to get me in a mental state of, okay, I'm going to create the conditions that I desire, okay? Now, why do I say you're telling on yourself? Because yesterday, which was the final day, the kits were supposed to run from this special, this sale, was supposed to run from Thursday to Monday. So yesterday was the last day. And oh my gosh, we say that in our profession, it is personal development with a compensation plan attached. It's personal development with a compensation plan attached. It's personal development with a what? Compensation plan attached. Everybody is focused on the compensation plan, though. A lot of people could care less about the personal development, and it shows. It shows when things don't go your way. When those kits ran out yesterday, or they didn't hit the site at the time they were supposed to hit, oh my gosh. I'm a part of a lot of chats. I'm a part of a lot of groups. And it was appalling to me, yes, I'm going to say it, to see so many people like, where they at? My nerves bad. My pressure going up. My customers getting frustrated. Let me tell you something. I had a customer that held the line for she was waiting for an hour for, because guess what? When you release a deal like that, where people save so much money on the top selling products, everybody's going to want it. Ding, 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 ding. So you should already know that the system is going to be overloaded. Do you know when the system wasn't overloaded? Thursday, when they first released the kits. So if people had not waited, they could have gotten their kit easy peasy breezy. But you got to take responsibility, and you got to realize when you play a role in your own self-sabotage. Right? So my customer waited for an hour for the server because they did some things to the server because they realized, you know, wow, we really have a huge bottleneck here. And I'm sitting here looking at distributors spazzing out while my customer is cool as a fan, cool as a cucumber. Okay, after she got her, I think it was like 45 minutes, and she was like, I finally got my kit. I was like, awesome, girl. She was like, thanks so much for what you do and keeping us in the loop and da-da-da-da-da. That was an awesome savings. I'm excited. And I'm looking at my customer who is not a part of this profession. She's just a customer. She doesn't get paid to do this. And if we say, if we're supposed to be advertising to people that you can come here, you can earn money and become a better person, why are we not living examples of that? This is why you can't recruit. This is why you can't get customers, because your energy is whack, because your energy is wrong. If people see you spazzing out, then guess what? They're gonna spaz out. Whatever you're doing, that's what your customers are gonna do. Whatever you're doing, that's what your team is gonna do. If you're in the chat, and God bless Scott Banya. God bless him. Okay, I call him Big Banya. Because Scott Banya, he is one of our corporate employees, and he's in a chat with some distributors, and oh my gosh, every single time there's an issue, people go to the chat like he don't work here. Scott Banya, what's going on? Scott Banya, when is going? Scott Banya, Scott, I said, man, if I was Scott Banya, I would break this chat. I would either get out the chat or just close the chat. Y'all wouldn't be calling my name like that. I promise you, TLC makes me want to be a better person, because when I look at them and I look at Jack Fallon and I look at how many people, when things are going right, they're like, oh my gosh, God bless TLC. And when things are not to their liking, then they catch attitude. When this, when that. You got to realize that people are looking at you all the time. And if they go on a TLC live, they might not tell you. And if they see you in the comments down below spazzing out, they're not going to join you, because nobody wants to be with somebody that has that nervous energy like that. Nobody wants to be with somebody who cannot keep their cool. A large part of the reason why Obama was like one of the most popular presidents is because he always kept his cool. You have to be cool and calm under pressure. And if you're not doing that, then don't be surprised when you don't have customers. Don't be surprised when you don't have recruits, people wanting to join your team. It's not something that you don't recruit right before you put up a recruiting post. You don't recruit right after. You recruit all the time. All the time people are looking at you. All the time people are watching you. All the time people are looking at how you handle certain things. All the time people are looking at whether or not you practice what you preach. And if you think these customers not on these company Facebook Lives, then you're a fool. Half the time my customers get to the Facebook Live before I do.
Hi, Miss Keisha.
And they're looking at you, okay? And they're paying attention to how you maneuver. But you're telling on yourself, because every single day you are not engrossed, obsessed. You don't have a burning obsession with personal development. PD constantly, PD daily, PD consistently. I preach that to my team all of the time. And you can't just do it. Okay, I read my 5 minutes today. I did an hour today. No, you have to live it. You have to live it.
Thanks.
Do y'all realize? If you are in my company, I just want to put some perspective here, okay? If you are in my company, because there are a lot of people that are not on my team and then watch my Facebook Lives. If you're in my company and you have a little, you know, you've been a little perturbed lately because the shipments have been a little slower, let's look at this through a different frame, okay? Do you realize that so many companies, right, there are MLM companies, their shipping time on the regular is like, they'll tell you like 7 to 14 days. On the regular, huh?
But I mean, like, because I don't
want... Yes, and I'll open it up. There are, I know MLM companies that do that on the regular. Do y'all know that there are companies right now, they ain't shipping out nothing. They're closed for business, period. So just the fact that we're open, right? Here you go. And we're just slightly slower than normal. It's a big dang on deal. And let me tell you something. No matter how slow the shipments are, they ain't been slow with that pay, have they? Daily pay has hit every day, right? And you like that. So you got to take the good with the bad. Don't say, I see more distributors complaining about the shipments than I see customers. How is that? And a lot of times, some of the delays with the shipments aren't even the company, it's UPS. Especially my customers that live in apartment buildings, UPS, because of Corona, because of the virus, because of things in the air, they've changed a lot of their restrictions. Some of my customers have had their packages left in areas because UPS didn't want to come too close, or whatever the case might be. Some of my customers in apartment buildings, they have had to go hunting for their packages. And thank goodness they've gotten them. Look, Asia is one. She's on the dang old lot. Asia, Asia is one of the ones that had that happen to her. But I see more distributors complaining about stuff than I see customers. Guys, let me tell you something. I do not care whether it's, and this is not just about MLM or business. It could be about a man. If you're looking for a man or you're looking for a woman, realize this. You are advertising yourself all the time. With social media, they are looking at you all the time. You're telling on yourself. You cannot say you want a God-fearing man, or you want this type of guy, or you want an ambitious man, or you want a guy who has all these tick marks and you have none of them. So if you're on social media, wilding out, talking about your ex, going crazy, tagging this person, doing crazy stuff that does not align with what the person that you desire would desire in a mate, you're telling on yourself. You're saying, I want something that I don't deserve. And in business, people do it all the time. They want something that they don't deserve. So I hear people complaining about the fact that, oh, I want a big team because I want a big check. Oh, okay, cool. But what are you doing to prepare for a big team? If you can't control your emotions by yourself, by your doggone self, what are you going to do when you have a big team? So all y'all going to be complaining? And complaining about what? I still don't get it. The company didn't have to release no kits after Thursday. If they said, hey, we budgeted for 10,000 kits, they sold out all on the first day, that could have been it. So the fact that they released anything was a big bonus to me. Another thing because this puts a bee in my britches. Another thing I want y'all to think about, if you're in my company, right? And shout out to Luann Kramer and Linda Farmer, because they were in the group with Big Banya, where everybody's like, Scott Banya, what's going on? Scott Banya, the system is giving errors. Scott Banya. Like, he don't know. Like, he don't work here. Like, he probably don't have 50 million other things going on, or 50 million other messages coming saying the same exact thing. Like, you gonna be the one to let him know that things ain't going right. Hilarious. I don't say a lot of things in those groups, because while most people are talking about the situation, I'm preparing for when the situation is over. You got to maintain your state. So, shout out to Linda Farmer and Luann Kramer, because I saw them in the thing going, this company does so much for us. They go above and beyond. They were trying to change the energy in the chat. See, that's what a leader does. Instead of joining in and saying, I know, right? This is causing me to stress eat. This is causing me to this. And you might think, oh, well, it was a joke. It was no big deal. But you got to watch what you put out there. Mm-hmm. Even in a joking manner, if it does not serve you in a beneficial way, then it's going to hurt you in a detrimental way. Period, point blank. Whether you mean for that to be the case or not. Another thing that I've seen, like I said, the shipping, the fact that packages, do y'all realize that corporate is working with the skeletal crew? The majority of people that are at corporate are now, a lot of them are at home. So when you discount prices so that sales go up, but you have a smaller crew, yeah, there are going to be some issues. That's just common sense. Yeah, there are going to be some issues. When you take the customer service reps out of the corporate building and they start working from home, they don't have the same infrastructure at their house that the corporate building has, right? There are corporate accounts for things, and then there are residential accounts. And there was very little turnaround time for any company to prepare for all their employees, or most of their employees, to be working from home. So yeah, calls might drop. Yeah, you might be on hold for a long time. But it is your job as a leader to figure out, how can I mitigate this circumstance? I have email templates for my team. I basically tell them, nobody should be on the phone. Nobody should be calling customer service. Send this email template, CC me on it, so that I know that you have a situation going on. In 24 to 48 hours, you follow up with me if you haven't heard back from them, and I'll escalate it. But guess what? The majority of my people are having their stuff fixed because they're simply following the plan that I, as a leader, laid out for them. So they're not sitting on the phone for 4 and 5 hours. And half the people that sit on the phone for 4 and 5 hours are doing so because they're not self-driven anyway. Asking customer service things that they can Google. Asking customer service things that's in their back office. Asking customer service things that aren't in videos that they just don't care to watch. They want to sit up there like P. Diddy and be like, tell me how to do such and such. Read it off for me while I eat my cheesecake. Man, if y'all don't get in that big office, back office, and y'all start clicking things, if y'all don't get in your emails, if y'all don't get in these apps, if y'all don't get, and I'm happy that y'all not on my team, because I'm telling y'all right now, I am not that network marketer who's like, I'm looking for 5 people, I'm looking for 10 people. I'm not looking for nothing, because I don't have to go looking for it. Everybody I'm supposed to work with will find me. Everything that I'm supposed to have will find me, because I said so. I'm not looking for nothing. And I'm telling you right now, if you are even remotely thinking about joining my team, you best to be self-driven. You best to want to step outside of your comfort zone. You best to want to do something different to get something you never had. Otherwise, I'm not in the mood to work with you. I'm really not. Because I have to work with people that are only interested in participating in their own rescue. That's the only thing I care about. Fast start bonus, you know, that one time sign up, I really don't care. I'm in this thing for the long haul. I want the long money. You hear me? So I need you to stick around. Not just when things are great, but when things are down. I need you to understand that this is a what? Personal development. Personal development plan with a compensation, just with compensation attached. You get paid to become a better person. You get paid to become a person of higher value. You get paid to solve problems. So stop acting like you don't want no problems, please. And if you do, if that's who you are, stay away from me. Stay away from me. I was listening to Dr. Mike Murdoch today, this morning, and he was talking about wisdom keys. And one of the things that he said is problems are the doors to money. See, problems are the doors to money. And what angers you will lead you to your anointing. If you pissed off about being broke, then your value, your income is going to go up when you figure out how to solve the problem of being broke. And then you turn around and you teach others that. See, that's how that works. That same audio that I was listening to when I started this conversation, Stormy Willen was saying, there's another part of the audio, and she was saying, and I'm not on Stormy's team, because I get that question a lot too. I'm not on Stormy's team. But guys, you don't have to be. You can listen to different people. And you can listen to different things. And you can have. And Stormy and I, we're in the same age group. But we could not be more different. Everybody doesn't have to be like you. You don't have to agree with everything they do. Learn how to eat the meat and spit out the bones. Learn how to eat the meat and spit out the bones. Shut up complaining about stuff. It's so irritating. Nobody likes somebody who's always complaining. That's why nobody's joining your team. That's why nobody's buying your products. You think it's the products. You think it's the company. You think it's Corona. No, it's you. It is you. What was I saying? Stormy Wellington said on another part of that audio, she said, look, one of my customers on here. See, that's what I'm saying. Like, I don't understand. And you have to call people into your life. I have been calling good customers into my life. Customers that are committed to the journey. They don't want a fad diet. Good customers with a good mentality. Good customers that are patient with me because they understand I'm a single mom. And guess what? I still got to eat. I still got to sleep. I still got to bathe. I still got to do other things, right? Good customers. And I'm telling you, the quality of my customers is better than the majority of MLMers out here selling stuff. The quality of my customers right now is better, and my customers aren't required to do personal development. It's really amazing. But in that audio, Stormy Wellington was talking about, and in case y'all don't know, she's like the top, she's not like, she is the top selling Black African American in MLM. That's a big deal because women are 80% of network marketing. But when you look at the stage, when you look at the leaders, oftentimes it's not women on stage, it's men. And half the time it's the husbands of a woman who started their business long ago, and the husband was like, I don't know if that'll work, honey, but you go ahead and do your thing. And then when her income took off, then the husband was like, well, hold on now, what we got here? And now they're all of a sudden a team. Shout out to all the men, okay? Not hating on you, just saying, these are facts, right? So the majority of leaders, the majority of people that you will see in this profession on stage are men. So for Stormy Wellington to not only be a female, but to be Black at that, and have done what she's done, you got to give props where props are due. Law of recognition, Dr. Mike Murdoch, right? So she was saying in the audio that back in 2008, she was like, I sucked when I was talking to people. It was horrible. I didn't know what to say, but I kept saying stuff. I kept studying people and I kept looking at what people responded to. And if they responded positively to something I said, I made a note of it. And I said more of that thing. And if they responded to me negatively or the conversation went backwards, I made a note of what I said. This is not genius tactics, guys. This is common sense stuff. What is your point, Kim? My point is this. She's talking about 2008. That wasn't that long ago. Do y'all understand that wasn't that long ago? 2008 was 12 years ago. As of the making of this video, it's 2020. 2008 was 12 years ago. That wasn't that long ago. But thank goodness that she had the good common sense to say, you know what? I'm not closing everybody. I'm not making the sales I need to make. But let me keep doing this because eventually I'm going to get it. You know why? You know why it's good that she did that? Because the time is going to freaking pass anyway. If she had quit in 2008, she wouldn't be where she is right now in 2020. If I had quit in my first company when I couldn't give away products for free, I wouldn't be where I am in this company right now, experiencing explosive growth in my team, in my income, and during a time when most people are paralyzed with fear. During most time when most people's checks are going backwards, I have my team getting bonuses. People brand spanking news. They don't have no influence. They don't have no influence. They don't have tons of Instagram followers. They are just committed to becoming better people, and they're following the freaking plan. That's it. That's what they're doing. The time is going to pass anyway. There are people right now in this current environment, and they are so happy. Because they've been waiting for a time such as this. Hey, how you doing? I know I can't take it.
You wanna take it?
Oh, I can't? Okay, then, cool. Are you new?
I'm just filling in.
Okay, well, welcome. Welcome to the neighborhood.
It's been a while since I've been on this side.
Okay, well, you take care of yourself. Appreciate you. Okay, we all shopping at Amazon, eh? Oh, packages still come. Okay? They still come. TLC. They're still coming. They're still coming. The time is going to pass anyway, guys. So if you don't like where you are, you do have a choice. You have a choice just like I had a choice. You have a choice just like Stormy Wellington had a choice. You have a choice just like all my better bodybuilders have a choice. You have a choice just like all my better body VIPs, my customers have a choice. You can get fat during this time or you can slim down. You can make money during this time or you can stay broke. Man, this stimulus check ain't enough. What's $1,200? What's $1,700 gonna do? Not jack squat diddy. If you're waiting for the government to save you, newsflash, they've been showing you for years that ain't gonna happen. The stimulus is not supposed to save you. You are supposed to save yourself. And there are some people right now that's Netflixing themselves to death, drinking themselves to death, doing all the wrong things with this time. And there are other people right now that say, you know what, you know, I'm going to use this down period like a trampoline. Like I'm going to go all the way down, but I'm going to bounce all the way back up, because I promise you, everybody is not struggling right now. I had a customer that was looking at 53 acres of land. They had 3 thriving businesses on it. We talking on the phone and he was like, yeah, I'm just going to see if this price is so low because they're in a bind or because something funny that they left out. But if everything checks out and it's just because they need to sell, the deal is done. 53 acres, 3 thriving businesses. He's one of my customers. He lives in Texas. Everybody ain't broke. Y'all got to learn that. And y'all got to start getting around some people that are not broke. And you have got to start speaking life to yourself, to your team, to your customers, to people you haven't even met yet, and even to your dang goal enemies. You gotta stop focusing on the wrong things. One of the wisdom keys from this morning was, if you focus on your adversary becomes your master. And I was like, wow. If you focus on your adversary becomes your master. And your adversary can be a person. Your adversary could be a poverty, a condition, or circumstances, whatever. But if you focus on your adversary becomes your master. If you don't broke, if you don't like being broke, do something about it. If you don't like being unhealthy, do something about it. If you don't like anything in your life, do something about it. But do not complain about it if you're going to simultaneously create the condition where you are accepting of it. You've got to become really, really radical about change for things to change. That's it. Period. Point blank. Now, my son done took my dang phone. I wanted to outro with it again so y'all get it through y'all head that you have to speak life to yourself. Well, that's not realistic. Man, reality is subjective. Your reality is not my reality. So when you say things like that's not realistic, again, you're telling on yourself. Because that's your reality. When people in my company complain about the phone system right now, customer service right now, you're telling on yourself. No personal development. Every time I hear somebody say I'm frustrated, in my mind, what I hear is, I don't do personal development. I don't do PD. I just want the money. Every time somebody says, Kim, I'm overwhelmed. I don't do PD. I just want the money. Every time somebody says, I don't know. I don't know. Nobody's buying. Everybody's broke. No, it's the corona. Corona done took everybody cash. In my mind, what I hear is, I don't do PD. I just want the money. We're lucky to have a customer service at all, let alone for them to still be operating 24/7, let alone for them to be upgrading the customer service system, and for Jackie Fallon and John Licari and Big Banger not to come to us and say, hey, reps, listen, y'all are doing a great job selling stuff, so great that we had to upgrade the phone system, so we're going to have to pass on that cost to you in the form of an extra 10. They could do like the dang old stupid universities, right? We're going to have to charge y'all $10 to $20 per month technology fee. They don't do that, though. So did anybody think about that? Did anybody think about the fact they're upgrading systems? They're upgrading things. They're giving away more money. They're giving away more deals. They're giving more, 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 according to our core values, right? According to, that's one of our core values, right? They're giving more than what's expected. And they're asking for zero in return. But you can't be patient. You can't be calm. You can't be cool. You can't be collected. You can't be the person that sets the tone like a Luann Kramer or what's her name? Linda Farmer. And helps people gain a different perspective on things, right? If I hold it like this, you can only see my glasses. If I hold it like this, you can only see my neighbor's door. What is the frame through which you look at things? Same scene, but whatever you're focusing on in that scene will determine how you feel about it. And a lot of times we can't see the picture because we are within the frame. So I invite you today to get a grander look, a look with a broader scope at your business, at your life, at your relationships, at a whole bunch of stuff. Whatever you want, whatever you desire, you can have. But you got to start calling it to your life in advance. You've got to start seeing it before you have it. See it with your spiritual eye before you can have it with your physical hand. You've got to start feeling the emotion, feeling the feeling of having it now. It's called future pacing. When you're in a current state, a current condition, and you're able to completely ignore it because you have put yourself in the feeling of having the future desired outcome. When it's so real to you that what's surrounding you no longer matters, it's going to make a lot of people around you think that you're insane. Like, girl, don't you see the car you driving? Girl, don't you see the house you live in? Girl, don't you see? Don't worry about them. Don't worry about them. A season of separation is coming from them jokers, from them heifers. A season of separation is coming. And anybody who's not going with you will get left behind. It doesn't make them a bad person. You're just not in the same. You're not in the same place, so you cannot encompass the same space. No longer. No longer. This corona epidemic is serious. People are dying. People are sick. People are losing jobs. But do not let fear paralyze you. Faith and fear cannot coexist. You change the frame through which you look at this thing. You get on your P's and Q's and do something you've never done before so that you can finally, coming out of this thing, start to get the things that you've never had before. I'm excited. Okay? In case you can't tell, I'm excited. And anybody who's not excited, stay your butt away from me. Bye.